I'm Michaela Lieberman-Martin. I am a senior health attorney at the Legal Aid Justice Center here in Charlottesville, where I represent folks experiencing poverty on various health law matters and health equity issues.
And I'm Diane Pappas, and I'm a professor of pediatrics at the university. And I work out in the Orange Clinic, so I work with a very rural population, and I'm very much focused on social determinants of health and how we can help families overcome barriers to getting health care.
So our project sought to examine and study and capture and measure the common barriers that face non-citizen children who are legally eligible for Medicaid when they're trying to access Medicaid. And those barriers include, but aren't limited to, things like lack of knowledge, not knowing what Medicaid is, let alone who's eligible for it, language barriers, folks who realize they may be eligible for Medicaid, but when they go to enroll are not presented with forms in their preferred language, being told that they're not eligible when in fact they are eligible by folks who are enrolling, should be enrolling them in Medicaid, various barriers, in addition to just sort of overall fear, which we've found to be widespread, certainly among clients that I work with and families that I work with, just around sort of using any form of public assistance, even when they may be legally entitled to do so.
And the other piece to this project is really to look at the longitudinal healthcare utilization patterns for these children. So are they overutilizing the emergency room or not utilizing any care or not accessing primary care, depending on their Medicaid or insurance status? And if we get them enrolled in Medicaid, are they then able to utilize preventive care in a more positive fashion, in a more preventive fashion, and less utilization on the emergency room or delayed care, which we know happens a lot?
We were lucky enough to design, with the help of wonderful public health students and medical students and directly affected community members, a series of survey instruments that we then used to ask study participants, parents or guardians of non-citizen kids who are eligible for Virginia Medicaid, questions about their experience trying to enroll their children in Medicaid and what their healthcare utilization patterns look like. And we were lucky enough to talk to dozens of community members who shared invaluable insights with us, and we are still tracking those barriers. And at the same time, myself and my colleagues at Legal Aid Justice Center have been able to provide the necessary legal interventions to make sure that if there are barriers that can be addressed through legal recourse, that they are. Invaluable, I think.
I agree. I also think the knowledge base, like I know Medicaid, you know, pays bills, but the nuance of which kids are eligible and which kids are not eligible and how it affects this particular subpopulation, that was not my area of expertise. So you need both sides.
Absolutely.
To come together to make this make sense.
Yeah, absolutely.
And figure out how to address an issue that obviously was brewing in both camps.
Exactly, exactly. And I think when we're talking about an issue like healthcare coverage, it is so inherently multifactorial, right? Whether it's knowing the eligibility rules, whether it's knowing the benefits of healthcare coverage, maybe it's understanding what your child's health needs are and having a trusted provider that you can go to who can translate in, you know, in understandable terms why it's valuable to have health insurance. Those issues can't be addressed by any one professional alone. And so I think our partnership, because we often work at the intersection of our disciplines, our partnership really lent itself well to this program, where we could more holistically answer the questions, meet the needs, hopefully, of our study participants and the greater client community. We would not have been able to do this project without the expertise derived of our study participants' lived experience and many of our advisors' lived experience being directly affected by this very issue. It simply, the data had to come from them.
And the data don't exist. I mean, what we know is that we don't know very much about this population. People don't study it. It's a hard population to access. And so really working together to get this information, we needed collaboration.
Yeah.
Because this data is not like bubbling up to the top just naturally.
Right, right. And I think from my perspective, as somebody who works at a community lawyering organization, right, an organization that seeks to work alongside and in many ways behind community members, putting their voices ahead of our sort of technical academic expertise so that their needs really govern all of our advocacy campaigns. It was really important, I think, for us to think about how to build power in these communities that are so often left out of the conversation and not captured in the data, despite there being interest in understanding what healthcare utilization patterns look like for folks who aren't citizens. So, you know, and I think, to be honest, we are always seeking to be even more inclusive and deliberate about involving and being steered by the lived experience expertise of directly affected community members. And I don't know that we nailed it this time. And I think that part of our job as practitioners and now as researchers, mm-hmm. if I do say so myself, is to be really critical of how we are engaging with the experts who are the study participants without extracting the information from them too.
I think you have to reach out to people who have your passion.
Yeah.
And I have found that my best collaborators in anything have been people outside of my discipline because they bring a different perspective. And so almost all of my projects have been beyond my department. So outside, find other people because they have very different skills and very different knowledge base that can really push you forward so much faster. Because of your work, I can help way yeah. more families then I can help seeing patients one at a time, right? We're gonna be able to leverage what we have, hopefully, to change the way Medicaid is applied in the state for lots of families. And that's a huge impact that I couldn't have without this collaboration.
For more information about iTHRIV and Team Science, please visit our website.